A rebellious child, his relationship with his mother was always troubled. She would nag and hit him incessantly.
Errol's mother, Merrell, was a descendant of one of the bounty mutineers.
We had a sword of Fletcher Christians, which is part of my mother's family. And I used to play with this thing and play soldier like any small boy, of course.
Despite the name Flynn, Errol wasn't from Ireland, as studio publicists would later claim. He was Australian, born in Hobart, Tasmania on June the 20th, 1909. Growing up near the ocean, the sea became his passion. It was a love he inherited from both his parents. His father, Theodore, was a professor at the university, a respected marine biologist. Errol said, "He was supremely patient with me, though I gave him nothing but trouble." He didn't find the same patience in his mother. He claimed she beat him, and his animosity towards her was profound.
She was a very controlling person, and Errol could be persuaded, but you couldn't dictate to him.
For the first time, I heard a man use a four-letter word for his mother. He didn't like his mother at all.
They were like two pieces of steel being rubbed together, that sparks flew. And that lasted up to the day he died.
Merrell was young and beautiful, originally from Sydney. She liked travelling, away from Hobart. His parents spent long periods apart. Neither was completely monogamous.
Errol was always being dumped off in boarding schools. And many times he told me he was the one student left on a holiday that didn't go home. And that resentment just was always there.
"I was in revolt against all formal schooling," he said. So school became a place for girls, sports, and pranks. Not surprisingly, he was often expelled.
This time, I'm gonna do my best to make it right and go on without you by my side. Hold on, shelter, come and rescue me out of this storm and out of this cold. I need.
One more chance and love.
Loving you.
One more chance. the fields and scatter the good seed on the land. But it is fed and watered by God's almighty hand. He sends the snow in winter, the warmth to swell the grain, the breezes and the sunshine, and soft refreshing rain. All good gifts around us are sent from heaven above.
So thank the Lord, oh thank the Lord for all his love.
Consider the lilies of the field. They don't work, they don't spin. And yet I tell you, Solomon in all his splendor was not attired like one of these. Now if that's how God clothes the grass, which is here today, and tomorrow is thrown unto the fire, will he not all the more clothe you?
Thank me then, O Father, for all things bright and good, the seed time and the harvest, a life, a health, a food. No gifts have we to offer,
and let us have a feast to celebrate this here day, for this son of mine was lost and is found, was dead and has come back to life.
For your brother here was dead and has come back to life, metaphorically speaking.
Just because it's in print doesn't mean it's the gospel.
It's a secret.